Hi, I'm Valeria, and this is my podcast, episode 1. Today, I'm going to be discussing the book, This Is How You Lose the Time War. This book has over 87,000 ratings and almost 18,000 reviews on Goodreads, which I think says a lot. And after looking at all the reviews, the 5-star reviews, everybody basically says the same thing, that this book is very impactful and it's written in a very beautiful way. This book was published in 2019 by Amal Al-Mortar and Max Gladstone. My reason for picking this book up was because I was super fascinated in the whole time travel aspect between two enemies sending letters to each other. This book follows two agents from rival agencies in a war who spark up an unlikely correspondence. The two agents are Red and Blue. Red belongs to the agency, a post-singularity that's very technological. Blue belongs to Garden, a single vast consciousness embedded in all organic matter. I also heard that the writing style was very unique, and after reading this book, I can confidently say that it was written in a very unique manner. I think it being written by two different authors, at some point you can tell that it was written by two different authors, but in the end, I think that it flowed very nicely. The whole letters and regular chapters, they were all very short and condensed, but so much was said in every chapter. And by the end, I was so impacted by this story, and I'm super grateful that I was able to read this book, because I did myself find them very interesting and fascinating. So Blue, she belongs to the Garden, and something that she can do is shapeshift, which is something that I never really read in any other book. I thought, wow, like, this, you know, woman can shapeshift. She shapeshifts into like this six-legged wolf, and then she mentioned shapeshifting into like a fish and a bird. And I was like, in the beginning reading that stuff, I was like, is she actually shapeshifting, or is this like a metaphor? Is this like something symbolic? I was very confused. But then I remembered, oh, Red has cameras in her eyes and she's basically a robot. And then I remembered, oh, this is a science fiction, so she is actually shapeshifting, which after thinking of it that way, it really gave more to the story, and it was so much more fun to read that way. In the beginning, I was so confused. I was like, I don't understand how they're time traveling, how this is working. But by the end, you know, everything came together. I was still very confused, and to this day, I'm still very confused, but I think I got a lot out of it. And after going back and skimming through the book, I understand things that the first time reading it around, I did not understand. So something that I really liked about the book is that not only did I have a sense of tranquility, I guess is the word, like, I was very chill while reading some chapters, but towards the end, I was very, you know, I had this angsty feeling, and there was definitely tension because, again, Blue and Red are enemies, and they're sending letters to each other throughout time, and this could be very risky. And throughout the letters, they say things that can, in the end, compromise them, and the other person could use against them to win the war. So there's this like sense of trust, but obviously if they do get caught, not everybody will see it that way. They'll either look like a betrayal, or they're posing with the enemy. So towards the end, you know, that tension picks up, and I do think that the tension buildup and the angst that was built up throughout the novel was very well done, because in the beginning, you know, I'm very confused and I don't know the characters well enough to make assumptions or theories. And in the end, or closing in on the end, I'm still a bit confused, but I have a better understanding of the world and the characters. And then now that I have that, I'm also thinking about everything else, and not only the characters, but the threats that they pose to each other. And I did mention this earlier, but I really did like the short chapters and short letters. I think a lot was said, and a lot of necessary things were said in those short chapters. And when I say short chapters, they were very short. They were only like 2 pages. And towards the end, the chapters do get a bit longer, but only up to like probably 6 pages. So they weren't too long. I think Blue and Red, even on page, I knew who I was reading about. I wasn't confused, like, oh, am I reading about blue or red? Like, I knew. And I think that was a very good thing done by both of the authors, because it is done by both authors. And from what I'm assuming by the cover, Max Gladstone's name is red and Amal El-Motar's name is in blue. So I'm assuming Amal wrote blue's chapters and Max wrote red's, which, you know, sometimes I could notice that in red's chapters, there were some things like flowery writing that was a bit different than blue's chapters, and also some rhyming. So there are some times that I can notice a bit of a difference, but it's really not that detectable. And in the end, I think that every chapter flowed very nicely. And there were some times that I forgot this book was actually written by two people. I was like, oh my goodness, these two people have like different voices. So in the end, I knew who I was reading about. I knew the differences between blue and red, but even the differences between the writing structure and writing style between the two authors, I think it still blended out very nicely in the end. And I would recommend this novel to some people. I think it's definitely not for a lot of people. I think you really have to keep an open mind and be sure of what you're reading. But I definitely had a good reading experience with this book, and I would recommend it to anybody that is looking forward to get into science fiction, or is, if you're already well versed in science fiction, I think you should definitely pick this one up. And I think this was a 5 out of 5 for me. But with that being said, this is the end of my podcast, episode 1. Thank you for listening, and I'll catch you in the next one.